There are two bags which contain blue and red balls. First bag contains 5 blue and 3 red balls, while second bag contains 4 blue and 6 red balls. One ball is randomly transferred from first bag to second bag without checking its color. After that, one ball is randomly picked from second bag. If ball picked from second bag is red, then find the probability that ball transferred from first bag to other was red. You are watching Brain Explorers, the world where brain starts working. This problem proves the fact that probability depends on given information. If we know everything about an event, then according to us, its probability is either 1 or 0. Here are the two bags, first one containing 5 blue balls and 3 red balls, and second one containing 4 blue and 6 red balls. It is given that one ball is transferred from first bag to second bag, then a ball is randomly picked from second bag, which is then observed to be red. Here all the balls have equal chances of 1 in 8 of getting transferred. In total, there are 8 balls in which 5 are blue, so there are 5 ways to transfer blue ball and 3 ways to transfer red ball. When one ball is transferred to second bag, then there are 2 possibilities for the second bag. In first case, there are 5 blue and 6 red balls because one blue ball is added in the second bag. Similarly, in the second case, there are 4 blue and 7 red balls. But we do not know which condition of second bag we have. If we have first condition, then there are 5 ways of selecting a blue ball and 6 ways of selecting a red ball. If we have second condition, then there are 4 ways of selecting a blue ball and 7 ways of selecting a red ball. It is given that ball from second bag is red. So, remove the cases of these blue balls. Let's calculate in how many total number of ways this given process can be done. 5 for blue times 6 for red plus 3 for red times 7 for red. Number of elements in sample space comes out to be 51. We have to find the probability for the second possibility of this bag because it is obtained by transferring a red ball. Number of elements in the set of favorable events is 3 times 7, that is 21. So, probability is 21 over 51 or 7 over 17. Here is an alternate method. Actually, the method works on the same concept but in a formal manner. Let us assume that E1 is the event of transferring a blue ball from first bag to second bag. E2 is the event of transferring a red ball from first bag to second bag, and E is the event of selecting a red ball from second bag. PE over E1 represents the probability of occurring event E when E1 already happened, means the probability of selecting a red ball from second bag when it is known that blue ball is already transferred from first bag to second bag. In this case, there are 11 balls in second bag, out of which 6 are red. So, PE over E1 is equal to 6 over 11. Similarly, PE over E2 is equal to 7 over 11. Event E can occur after either E1 or E2, thus probability of E is equal to PE1 times PE over E1 plus PE2 times PE over E2. We have to calculate PE2 over E, means the probability that a red ball was transferred from first bag to second bag when it is known that red is selected from second bag. This is equal to PE2 times PE over E2 upon PE. On calculation, we get required probability equals to 7 over 17. Let's move to our another question. Find the general formula for the nth term of a sequence whose first term is 1 and all other terms are related to previous term with the following recurrence relation. Try this question and send us your solution, and if you have any question like this, then please share with us. Don't forget to like and share our video, and for more such videos, subscribe to our channel Brain Explorers. Thanks for watching.